I'm here at the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy in Oxnard. I ask you descending questions to Robert Garcia, trainer of the year 2012. Do you agree?
Yeah.
Right. Is that what champions eat?
Yeah, hell yeah. Yep.
That's fine. Take
so we ask him to send in questions.
Got a lot of questions.
You're a trainer here. You can ask some questions.
Yeah, I'm asking some questions.
Okay, let's go. Question number one.
All right. Eddie Favela just wants a shout out.
Eddie who?
Eddie Favela.
Eddie Favela?
Favela? Favela.
Eddie Favela. What's up, Eddie? How you doing?
You just made his day.
Just made his day.
True. Says, what's up, Robert? I know it's not up to you, but damn, I would love to see Rios versus Danny Garcia. Tell Cameron Duncan.
if it was up to me and Cameron Duncan, we would have done it maybe a couple fights ago. But
a lot of people. I did a poll on ESPN's reporting that three names that people wanted to see. They said Danny, Rios, Danny Garcia, Amir Khan, Danny Garcia, Matisse.
I'll tell you one thing. They're both interesting fights, and he already beat Amir Khan, so it makes it a little more interesting. But I think all three beat him. I think all three could beat Danny Garcia.
Yeah.
Honestly, I think Amir Khan on rematch will box him and beat him. Brandon would destroy Garcia, and I think Amir Khan... Lucas Matisse will probably give him a hell of a fight and stop him in the late rounds.
Okay, next question.
Next question.
I'm not hating.
Sam goes on. Rios versus Bradley looks more exciting at this point than Pacquiao versus Rios.
Rios versus who?
Bradley.
Well, hey, they both have the same manager, so I don't think that's a fight that would happen because they both have the same manager. So why would we even talk about it? Plus Bradley's a good fighter. It would be interesting, but
isn't Bradley also 47 now? He went up to fight Manny.
That's right. Well, if Brandon, if Brandon has Manny, he'll probably go up too.
So already? Yeah, one fight?
Well, why not? He looks strong, right? He took the power. You know, it took him only 6 rounds. Watch. It was a hell of a fight, a hard fight. But it only took him 7 rounds to get Alvarado. It was like halfway a championship fight to knock Alvarado out. So that tells you a lot from a fighter that came up 135 to 140. That means he's stronger than he was at 135. So he'll be as strong at 147 also.
Manolo says, thanks for the shirt, Robert. Manuel in Rosemead, how many rounds should you hit the heavy bags during a workout? 4 to 5 times.
Heavy bag is very, very, very important workout. It's probably the best workout out there. You guys gotta hit the heavy bag hard and a lot of rounds. Sometimes even more than what you do during the mitts. I think the bag is the most important.
So Tapia's doing it right. 15 rounds.
The most important. The most important equipment in the heavy bag.
Some fighters don't believe in it though, Robert.
They should, because the heavy bag is very important.
If you see Mayweather train, Mayweather hits the heavy bag, you know, every day they're always showing him hitting the heavy bag.
Heavy bag is very important.
Juan Zuniga wants you to know that good things happen to good people. That explains your success. Keep it up.
Well, Juan Zuniga. I've said it before, you know, what goes around comes around, and lately things have gone well for me, and I think it's good work, hard work, and also I've done right, you know, I've never done anybody wrong.
Why So Serious wants you to be his trainer one day?
Is he even a boxer? Why So Serious?
Why So Serious?
Okay, what does he have to do? Just come in the gym?
Just come in the gym. We got everybody. We got guys from everywhere that come and train here. They don't have to. You know, we have guys from all over the country, all over the world that come here, and they have a great time.
Lewis Watson, THFC.
You see? What, she's a girl?
Okay,
she likes to party and get high.
She was lonely.
I don't know.
Do you get high?
Yeah.
Yeah, mom. That's why she's here.
How old
are you? She's here.
15.
Oh, 15. Oh, wow.
That's why you're here, right?
Yeah.
But next year she have a driver license?
But that's why she's here, because she's been getting in trouble. Right?
Yeah. Messing up in school.
See, the boxing is a good good sport to keep you out of trouble. You're gonna like it. Yesterday was your first day, right?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I like it. Once you start meeting and start hanging around, you'll like it.
Yeah, I guess. There's no girls here.
So what?
Even she's better,
right?
Here. Yeah.
There you go. There's guys, plenty of guys.
Even better.
Hey,
Robert. But they know better. They know not to do wrong stuff. So you learn that from them.
Here. And how did they treat you here?
Like one of the guys.
Like one of the guys. It's good, right? Right? So this will be good for you.
You can make a lot of friends here. They're very cool.
My dad just took me here to get me out of the house.
That's good.
And are you doing good?
Yeah. No, you just did.
Okay, grab a jump rope.
Look,
15 minutes.
She didn't come for like how long?
2 months.
2 months. She was getting in trouble at school, getting in fights.
She was beating all the boys up.
Getting in fights at school. And now she came back to the gym because she's gonna strain out.
But she's very talented. I've seen her spar.
Oh, yeah.
No, I'm not gonna
jump rope with her. Jump rope with her.
Make her feel at home.
Yeah, make her feel at home. She's your training partner today.
Yeah.
Lewis Watson, he wants to know your thoughts on the legend of, or the legacy of Prince Nassim Hamed.
Prince Nassim Hamed didn't have a long career as a world champion, but the few fights that he had and that he was showing here in the United States, very exciting. Everybody wanted to see him fight. He became very popular, and within a fight or so, he was so popular the whole world knew who he was. Made a lot of money. So
yesterday, a trainer told me that because of him, all the lightweights are making money. Because before him, they didn't pay lightweights.
Well, he was a featherweight, actually.
I'm saying, like,
no, yeah, junior lightweight, featherweight, yeah, he was a featherweight, I think.
But he made the most money. He opened up the doors for Manny, for Mayweather.
He started making a lot of money, and yeah, it was him. So you know, he is going to be a legend. He is a legend, right?
Did you ever fight with him on the same card?
No, but we were champions at the same time. Never fought him for that. But he was a legend. He could punch too.
If you fought him, would you beat him?
I don't know, dude.
Okay. He came into the ring on a flying carpet, yeah. Jumping over. What did you do when you came in?
Nothing. I just walked into the ring. Business time. Grab some gloves. Come on, guys.
Saheed, he's making his debut on Friday. Unlicensed boxing. Any tips or advice?
Unlicensed boxing?
I think that's against the law, isn't it?
He's fighting on an unlicensed card?
Fuck
it, do what you gotta do. Fuck him up. Whoever it is. Bite him. If there's no license, they don't have...
No, unless it's a European term that he's not a professional. Maybe he's an amateur?
Maybe he's an amateur. Well, hey, best of luck, and hopefully things go well.
Dale Mussington, do you think American boxers respect British boxers?
Well, at least I know that... They should. We do. I do. Why not? British boxers are very talented. They're very tough. They come to fight. So that's one thing you gotta respect.
Carl Froch, Ricky Haddon, Prince Nassim, Amir Khan.
You gotta respect that. All of them. You gotta respect them.